Welcome again, and we will try to see the opportunities in indenting for indenter. So this will be like a summary, you know, that this is what is this business like, and how we went through the process, and how it will be useful for us as a total team, as a business, you know, business model. So indenting business for indenter means for me or for you, if you become a kind of a facilitator on behalf of supplier or sometime customer. So this is a no risk, no investment, almost no documentation except your commission invoice and minimum compliance. So this business is no investment, no risk, or little investment means calling or something like that, as we discussed before, and almost no documentation, only commission invoice for indenter is to be raised. Other all documents are between buyer and supplier, and they are issuing it, you know, as we have seen in the steps, like a contract is issued from the supplier, the LCE, letter of credit, is given by the buyer, so on and so forth. Then 200 plus countries to do sourcing. So same way, 200 countries to do selling or exports, right? So as a indenting, you are supposed to source from overseas, and you can source from 200 countries. But same way, reverse indenting, from your home country, you are in a position to sell anywhere in the world. So 200 countries can be also your client countries, or some of them, you with the choice, you select and you go for them. Matchmaking with the customers and suppliers product and customers requirement, and get the confidence in the buyer and the supplier, right? So you'll get more deals done by the matchmaking, and what happens, the customer will realize that this indenter is really a good one and who is able to match the our product requirement, and so they will bring in new products. So automatically it goes into the autopilot of the existing product, and new products gets come to us. Choice to choose, indenter has a choice to choose his own products, product line, suppliers and customers. See, in any other business, I have never seen that you have a choice. You are in the same line and you have to give the material, you have to take the, you know, whatever the business relations to continue. But if you have a multiple lines, then you have a choice for selecting the product, suppliers or customers. If it is in a difficult position with some supplier or customer, you may over the time, you can change over that because you have various options, right? Expanse of this business is very huge. Indenting business is very huge because we are doing anything which will fetch you the money by liaising or by facilitating and matchmaking customer and suppliers, product and customer's requirement. So this is beyond geographical territories. It is not only the requirement of your home country, but even the other countries where you want to target it. So very huge business potential for in terms of India. A few years back, this imports was a $600 billion bill, import bill. So $600 billion is the market for the import sourcing as an indenting. Also, we can target the reverse indenting from home country, India, to other countries, which was few years back about $400 billion, right? So we can do the reverse indenting also, means we can take this, now supplier is from India or home country, and we can take the commission from them, and we can see the matchmaking of the customers for them and take the commission from the supplier. So both businesses are available with us. Even the local business can be looked into as an indenting without investing. So you have to make up your mind that no need to invest, and tell your supplier and a customer that, look, I can be marketeer for you, or I can be a sourcing agent for you, for the customers you can tell. So the total potential becomes, what you call the importing bill and the exporting bill of the your home country. So in case of India, like few years back business, it is 600 billion import and 400 billion export. So the total potential is $1,000 billion. Can you imagine if you multiply, if you are Indian, if you multiply by means 1,000 into crores, that is seven zeros and one, so that will be so big amount, it will go maybe out of calculator. Or if you have a 12 digit, when you multiply by a dollar, $1 is equal to say 75 rupees, then it will be really, really very huge. Maybe 80 lakh dollar crores. 80 lakh dollar crores. It's a huge, huge potential. Whatever you have, how much you can do, it is depending on you. If you are doing less, is a problem, because it's such a huge market available, right? And you can make this your networking through your mediators into various states in the your home country and to the other countries. Utilize your contract and give them also, make them also indented in those countries, so that we can have a networking and share our indenting commission of each other and make more business, because there is a very huge potential, $1,000 billion, kind of a market for the home country and outside going reverse indenting. So targeting, you have a total spectrum of the products. For example, I'll tell you, because this is, I'm summarizing. So petroleum products, like right from the crude oil to bitumen and MTO and so on, hexane and other products. So you are not going to immediately touch, as we said, for the crude oil, the biggies. But even the bitumen is 2.5 million ton is imported into India, and MTO and other hexane and so many products are. Then petrochemicals. So petrochemicals also, there is a huge imports coming in. So the capacities are, say, about 25 million ton. The production is 15 million ton and requirement is 40 million ton. And it is going to make the requirement, in next 10 years time, maybe 60 million ton, and the production may be about 25 to 30 million ton. So this gap is from 10 million tons, it will go to probably 20 million tons minimum, or even more if the product new plants are not coming in. So there is going to be gap into every segment of sectors, you can say, like petrochemicals, as I said, like you have from methanol to the chemicals like acetic acid and acetone and phenol and IPA, isopropyl alcohol, toluene, and so on and so forth. Then chemicals. So it will be any kind of, the finished chemical or intermediate chemical. So intermediate can be also another line. So this will be like a phthalic anhydride or malic anhydride. So it is, one is a raw material and that is a chemical, and then it is another product, intermediate is produced. So intermediate can be also sold, and the finished product can be also sold, right? So like polymers will be not very finished product, but maybe the two step before or one step before the finished product. So from ethylene, you can make a polymer like a kind of a polyethylene, or with the chlorine you can, or EDC, you can make ethylene plus EDC, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, then you can make a pipe or fittings or film or like that. So polymers is a very big segment, and another, say, maybe 50 million tons, the gap is there of the into the polymers. Then machinery, so it will be injection molding machinery, blow molding machinery, then CNC machinery, then agriculture machinery, and so on and so forth. It's a very huge market. A lot of imports are coming. There may be some specialized companies in India, those who are making specialized into agriculture, then you can export those machines also. So the same side, you are having import, like crude oil is coming by import, and base oil or transformer oil or other specialty chemicals going from outside, outside India. So it is for the one coin, both the sides. So these product categories are like that, from one product we make another product, value addition product, and we can export also. Then commodities like rice and wheat and cement is a commodity, and fertilizer. So one is an eatable or edible commodity, and another is non-edible, which is going into the bulk, or urea or fertilizer or kind of iron ore. So these are kind of the commodities market. Then minerals and ores. So again, here what is coming out of the excavation, you will have to have that ores kind of thing, and minerals, which countries are rich in that, and they are like a Chile and Malaysia for the copper, and so many huge deposits wherever you find that you can transfer it to the another countries, right? So this is a raw material kind of economies. And metals. So steel is there, or any other, copper is there, or nickel is there. So many metals are there. Then electronics, laptops, So electronic products, laptops, tablets, iPad, consumer durables, we know the refrigerators and TVs and all kind of, then catalyst, then drones, robotic, high-tech products, pharmaceuticals, so pharmaceutical finished product, penultimate product, and the raw materials, intermediate, so the whole gamut, fatty alcohols, edible oils like rice bran oil or palm oil or groundnut oil. So all oils is a huge consumption, maybe 50 million tons of the oils are coming, edible oils are coming to India, or fatty alcohols are coming, and then they are getting into converted into certain products. Then soap noodles, stearic acid, refined glycerin, wood, pulp, paper, newsprint, these are all coming in a huge kind of imports. And some special product or special paper can go as export, or out of that wooden this thing you create some other kind of stuff, and then you can export it also. But the huge consumption, because India is a big population of 135 billion, so that kind of market is available. Then medical diagnostic is really picked up due to this pandemic situation. So all kind of diagnostic equipments, x-ray equipment and COVID testing equipment, and the sensor kind of a testing is there, or there will be some raised testing will be there, or any new technology is coming up, and that can be the medical diagnostics can be also coming up. So sanitizers, then testing equipment, masks, so these are kind of a due to pandemic situation coming in. Agriculture machinery, which we have already seen, but it can be a plowing or harvesting or specific kind of agriculture machinery. Then automotive spare parts, then experienced manpower. So this is, no ending limit. This is a very huge thing. And we have seen in particular episode, why the import happens, and what are the products of import you see around, and same way, what are the export products. So this I just summarized. So after getting this all known thing, then we are going to make a kitty of our 25 products by doing, probably you want to do 100 products, but not to burden you. So I said only 25 products to select. So that will be taking, of your liking, and sibling product, and your hobby product, and not known product, or import, top 10 import or top 10 export products, and futuristic products kind of thing. So you can take a max mix of the kitty, and there is no restriction on minimum. So, or no restriction rather on a maximum, because you can take any number. You can take any number. More is better. More is better. Then out of which you will research, survey, screen it from 25. You will choose then 5 products, best product out of it, and out of which 2 to 5 products you will try to launch every year and try to make business out of it. Right. So if you do every year, say 5 products, then in 5 years you will have a 25 product. In 10 years you will have a 50 products in your kitty. So it is though additional new business, but it can become a main business also. So by earning this initial gestation period, 3 to 6 months time or 1 year time, you will do 2 to 3 launching of your products after the survey, research, and certain products are not suddenly changing the economics of this product, whether viable or suddenly not viable. So we'll have to go through that extra products, and we can try to make a kitty of 25 to 50 products in next 5 years to 10 years time. And this all business, you earn a lot of commission by repeating business with the many customers in your home country and other countries also. So once you have a kitty of your commission and the products, so what you can do, then you can think about 10% of the amount earned. That can, suppose you earn $1 million. So then you can invest about $1 lakh to try and see your luck if you want, because that's why I'm not taking this as a trading program. But actually, when you invest, it becomes a trading. It could have been taught as a, international trading program, but I'm saying indenting, because I don't want you to lose the money or invest the money at this situation. You try to learn between buyer and supplier. The entire transaction goes through you. You learn it out. You do hundreds of transactions, take expertise, and then you invest, and you can do only investment of 10% so that you don't lose any money, right? So like this, you will try to do by import sourcing, and same way, You can do the reverse indenting, that you can source from the home country and you can supply, and from exporters in India, you can take the commission. So this is how the expanse of this course is very, very huge. And I think if you really do it very sincerely and a hard work, and sky is the limit to earn the commission also, and you don't require much of manpower. Maybe, you know, you can handle single-handedly 5 products, 10 products. Once you become 50 products, 100 products, then probably you require to service all the verticals to get more money. Then you can have a product manager for each sector. Like, you know, in my case, I had, 10 sectors planned initially when I started the business. So like chemicals, then means petrochemical, intermediate, then machinery, then renewable product, then bulk commodities, and so on and so forth. So high-tech product. So what happens? You have a kitty developed over the period of time, and many of the different products are going to contribute to your kitty, and you always go on developing. So you become like a international indentor, or rather international subsequently trader. So it is, the expense is very huge, and there is no limit for it. I hope I have tried to explain you anything and everything about what I know. And in case you have any questions, probably you can get in touch with me for further consulting if you want to go into the deep, or if you have not understood, right? Thank you so much, and wish you all the best, and do happy indenting. Bye-bye. Goodbye. Thanks a lot.